What's up, guys? Back with another educational video, and this week we're talking about diet and inflammation. Now, there are a lot of claims out there made about anti-inflammatory diets and pro-inflammatory diets. And I think it's really important to separate feelings from data, because data doesn't care about your feelings, and our feelings will often lie to us. Therefore, it is very important to examine what the data actually says. Now, before we start discussing the data, I think it's really important to take a moment to talk about, when we talk about inflammation, what are we actually referring to? So there's a lot of confusion on this point. I've done a video previously about inflammation and how there are various forms of inflammation. Some inflammation is very healthy and part of normal processes. For example, if you get sick, there is an inflammatory response that is actually necessary in order for you to kill whatever infection you have, and is part of the healing process. If you have an injury, there is an inflammatory process that is helpful for the repair of that injury. If you lift weights, you have micro damage to that tissue, and there is an inflammatory response that is a normal part of that repair process. Those last two are forms of localized inflammation, and people confuse this all the time. So if you fall down and bruise your thigh, there's gonna be a localized inflammatory response. That has absolutely nothing to do with what's called systemic inflammation, which is basically inflammatory markers in your bloodstream. I'm not a CVD or cancer expert, so I'm not gonna pretend to be. My best understanding is that low-grade elevations in systemic inflammation are independent risk factors for heart disease and possibly some cancers as well. So if you get a bruise, you don't get cancer in that area, even though there's an increase in inflammation. However, if you have consistently elevated levels of inflammatory markers like CRP in your bloodstream over a long period of time, it increases your risk for various diseases. So again, we have to separate localized versus systemic. In fact, years ago when I injured my lower back, people on YouTube tried to say that I injured it because I eat sugar. Sugar increases inflammation, and therefore I got injured because I had high levels of inflammation. You don't understand how inflammation works. That is getting the cart before the horse. If you injure yourself, there will be an inflammatory response. But inflammation is not a precursor to injury. Inflammation is a response to injury. And that localized inflammatory response has absolutely nothing to do with systemic inflammation. So now that we've got that out of the way, let's discuss the role of diet in managing inflammation. Now, there have been a lot of claims from various diet groups about the superiority of their diet on inflammation. So for example, you've heard in the Game Changers, plant-based proteins are less inflammatory than animal-based proteins. You've also heard from the low-carb diet group that a low-carb or ketogenic diet is superior for improving inflammation compared to, say, a low-fat diet. And then you've had various other claims from various other groups. What does the research actually say? Well, unfortunately, there's not a lot of randomized control trials on this particular subject. If we look at the research, it doesn't appear that varying the macronutrients in the diet makes a whole lot of difference on inflammation when total calories are controlled or total weight is controlled. So there was a study where they looked at comparing a protein-based diet versus a carb-based diet versus a unsaturated fat-based diet. So they basically said that the unsaturated fat-based diet was kind of based off the Mediterranean diet. The protein-based diet increased protein by 10% and decreased carbohydrates by 10% in exchange. And then the carb-based diet was a 58% carbohydrate diet. And all of them were kind of what you would call healthy diets. They were modeled around the DASH diet, and they were low in processed foods, high in whole grains, you know, those sorts of things. So what did they find? Well, they found that all three diets improved inflammation and markers of inflammation with no difference between the groups. One difference they did see was that LDL cholesterol was improved a little bit better in the protein-based diet compared to the carb-based diet. It wasn't a huge difference, but there was a difference there. So some people might say, well, that's only, you know, a 10% exchange. That's not that much. And they were all eating healthy diets. There was another study that compared a very low-carb ketogenic diet versus a low-fat diet with calories equated. And again, they showed no difference in markers of CRP. Both groups improved their CRP markers, but we know that CRP will go down with weight loss. So as long as you lose weight, you will get reductions in CRP typically. Yet another study didn't vary the macronutrient content of the diet, but they looked at either using animal protein versus plant protein, calories and macros equated, and surprise, surprise, both groups improved their levels of CRP with no differences between groups. So there is some debate about saturated fat versus monounsaturated fat versus polyunsaturated fats with regards to their effects on inflammation. Some studies show no association of saturated fat with inflammation or an increase in inflammation with saturated fat, but these are observational studies. They're not controlling total calories. Some studies show an improvement in inflammation by replacing saturated fat with polyunsaturated fat. Again, not controlling calories and mostly observational. There's very few randomized control studies. Probably the strongest evidence for any one particular nutrient improving inflammation is the omega-3s. The studies are either neutral or show a benefit to replacing saturated fat with omega-3 polyunsaturated fat. There does seem to be possibly a benefit there of omega-3, but again, there are some disagreement between the studies, but overall, it tends to show a neutral or protective effect. So it doesn't appear to be a downside. Yet another claim is that sugar is inflammatory. And certainly, if you have people on high sugar diets, they tend to have higher levels of inflammation because they eat more calories, they add body fat. Adipose tissue itself is inflammatory because it secretes what are called adipokines, which are inflammatory. In studies where they control calories and vary the amount of sugar, there doesn't seem to be a difference in markers of inflammation. So it seems to be an energy effect. Now, again, as we have to caveat with sugar all the time, it is very difficult to eat a reduced calorie diet while also eating high sugar. High sugar tends to be in foods that are hyperpalatable and easy to overconsume, easy to eat too many calories. So from a mechanistic perspective, sugar may not be inflammatory, but from a practical perspective of trying to decrease intake to control overall adipose tissue so you're not secreting more adipokines, it may be practically inflammatory because it's difficult to limit your calories on a high sugar diet. So what's the takeaway from this? It seems to be more important to just control your overall fat mass. And whatever way you can do that, whatever diet allows you to do that consistently, provide the best adherence for you in the long term, and is the most sustainable for you as an individual, understanding that sustainable for one person may not be sustainable for another person. Whatever diet that is probably going to be the best diet for controlling inflammation. So far, there is no evidence that there is a special anti-inflammatory diet. Anyone claiming as such has no evidence to support their statements other than probably conjecture and maybe hacking together a bunch of animal studies with non-physiological protocols. It's all about trying to find something sustainable for you and controlling your overall fat mass. All right, guys, if you're interested in some of the studies I talked about, the links are in the description. Also, you can pick up some of my educational books, or you can check out our nutrition coaching app, Carbon Diet Coach, which can take a lot of the guesswork out of your nutrition based on your goals and individual metabolism, and it's only $9.99 a month. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I will catch you next week.